Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of New-TNA Xplosion. This is Zach Shore. I'm back, and I'm glad to be back. And right next to me is my good friend, Loudon. How you doing, buddy?
I am doing really good. Tonight, we have the main event, which is going to be a tag team match. Evan O'Shea and Michael Tarver against Steven Spryder and the returning Arcan. That's going to be something else.
Yeah, a lot of... This should be an interesting match. A big return for Arcan and Evan O'Shea is only second match since his return. And oh my! All right, Scott Steiner is out here to start his Freakzilla Invitational.
Oh yes, the Freakzilla Invitational because of last impact, that just despicable and heinous Invitational. That wasn't even invitational. It was just horrible. And Scott Steiner is basically coming out here to prove that he's a bigger man than Matt Morgan.
Exactly. Scott Steiner is going to show Matt Morgan how it's done. You don't prove you're the man by picking on people smaller than you. You prove you're the man by stepping up to the next challenge. And Scott Steiner is all about stepping up to that next challenge. Because he is the big Papa Pump.
That's right. That big Papa Pump will always be someone's hookup. Holla
if you hear me.
I like that. We were just like right on connection with that shit. That was nice. Mm-hmm.
We don't know who is answering Scott Steiner's Invitational. It could be anyone. They don't have to be a member of the new TNA roster. It could be anyone in the world of professional wrestling. Maybe even on the world of professional wrestling. Kimbo Slice could answer the champ.
Oh my Jesus!
Judas Priest! I think Kimbo Slice might have been the better alternative.
Holy motherfuck of God. That is the Big Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Big Show is here. The Big Show has answered the Freakzilla invitation.
Oh my God. This is going to be awesome.
500+ pounds of pure boxing badassery. Scott Steiner's got his work cut out for him tonight.
Indeed, this is gonna be David versus Goliath if David was a roided up freak like Scott Steiner.
It's definitely gonna be a challenge for Scott Steiner because Big Show maybe have about the same size as Matt Morgan, but he carries more mass and that devastating knockout punch.
He is devastating indeed. It's lights out when you get punched by the Big Show. In your jaw.
It's not just any roided up freak. It's the roided up genetic freak.
That's genetic right. Look at
this. Staring down. Scott Steiner's probably just surprised us. He's going to size Big Show up. And here we go into the lockup.
Yep.
Big Show overpowering Steiner. Oh, the headbutt.
Oh, my God.
Big Show with the most devastating head this side of the Isle of Samoa. Uh-oh. And raining down with those punches on the head of Steiner.
This is going to be a big challenge for Steiner because Big Show is just all about power. Oh!
Wait a minute. Steiner now. Oh, and Big Show with a counter. These men have actually clashed on a few occasions back in the...
Holy crap!
Stomping down on WCW. And oh my goodness!
Was that the Eye of Hurricane?
Big Show right now just dominating in the early minutes. And oh my... Oh, again with the heavy punches. Big Show has taken Scott Steiner totally by surprise.
Well, Steiner was not expecting the Big Show out of all people
good lord.
Holy mother of God.
That's
the first time I've ever seen Scott Steiner hit a moonsault or a shooting star press of sorts.
I have seen it one other place, but it was a different promotion. With a huge knife edge chop right across the chest, and
Oh my god.
Steiner's getting dominated in a way I've never really seen before, and cover. One, two. Oh! Steiner just able to force the shoulder. It would not do well for Steiner to lose his first invitational match. And Big Show with a thunderous powerbomb.
Nasty powerbomb.
Just stomping on the chest of Steiner. I've never seen Steiner get manhandled like this.
It has been quite a while since we've seen Scott Steiner get up. Oh my! Good lord! It has been We've seen this.
Even Goldberg didn't hand Scott Steiner his ass this bad. Look at this! Big Show's picking Scott Steiner up like a child!
Holy Jesus! And Steiner is no light person.
Steiner is no cruiserweight. He has beaten up four cruiserweights at once. And Big Show is beating him like those collective cruiserweights.
Oh my god.
Big Show now gonna toss Steiner back in the ring. Count is up to eight, or almost up to eight now. And
oh!
Count. A huge big boot right to the side of the head of Steiner. Big Show really working on the head and the back. The head for that deadly knockout blow, the WMD. And the back to weaken the suplex. Wait a minute!
Oh, Steiner!
Double underhook, Steiner flex! Look at the strength!
That's one!
Here we go, now stomping on Big Show's face. Steiner getting back in control. Now with the knife edge chops, Steiner with the offense, Steiner pouring on the blows. And wait a minute, what's Steiner doing here? Just picking him up and dropping his arm across the rope.
Trying to weaken that arm there. Nice elbow drop.
Elbow drop there right across the center of the chest, and wait a minute. He's got him. Another big blow to the back of the head. Here we go. Exploder Steiner Flex, number one. We're up to number two now.
Yes.
Two Steiner Flex. Two. Record still stands at seven. And here we go, number three.
Three
Steiner Flexes. Will we see the third exploding Steiner Flex, though? No. Big Show has secondary plans.
Big Show's like, you're not about to be a suplex highlight reel here. Now, Big Show.
Big Show putting him on the top rope.
Oh, God.
Uh-oh. Oh, this was a huge shot.
Wait, what is he doing?
Kick him down on the floor, but Steiner, it was Godwin. Gee, he just leveled the Big Show with that punch.
Caught Big Show off guard and leveled him, and now...
Oh!
Oh.
One way to do it.
Ooh. Right into the little shows.
Well, here we go. Another exploding Steiner Flex. We're up to four.
Steiner doing what he does best, suplexing the shit out of his opponent. And now...
Steiner feeling that swag, as they say. And he's tossing Big Show in the corner. His big clubbing blows to the back.
Another one.
Wait a minute. Oh! Big Show with that kick to the back of the knee, trying to weaken Steiner's legs. They got the strength of the suplexes and a big headbutt to the back of the head. Now Steiner's starting to go into the corner and a huge clubbing forearm to the back. And Steiner's going up. I don't like where this goes. Wait a minute.
Holy crap!
Sidewalk slam. And now here goes Big Show. One.
Two.
Oh!
No.
Just able to focus him out. Yes, here in New-TNA, we have rings reinforced with adamantium so they don't break from maneuvers like that or that huge spine buster.
Yes, apparently we got the same people who gave Wolverine his metallic body.
Oh,
look at this!
Showstopper. Here goes the Big Show. This could be it. One.
Two.
No.
Oh. Steiner kicked out of the Showstopper. Usually you don't see nobody kick out from
that. My goodness, big belly-to-belly suplex there. We're up to five. Five suplex Steinerplexes, ladies and gentlemen. We're two away from the record. Here comes Steiner. Big clubbing blows. A clothesline to the back of the head.
Very nice clothesline to the back of the head there.
Steiner.
He's got something planned here.
I got a plan. Oh, no. Oh, just dropping the throat across the ring rope. And wait a minute. Wait. Steiner going up top.
You ever see Steiner go up to the top rope before?
Doing diving clothesline. Diving
Steinerline.
Steinerline off the top rope. Oh my goodness. Steiner pressing the advantage. Now Steiner, what's he got? He'll throw Big Show into the ropes. Come on, big money. Power slam.
That is a power slam.
Strength of Scott Steiner. Steiner is an amazingly powerful individual, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a minute. What's this?
It is Frankensteiner!
Super Frankensteiner! Oh, what in the fuck?
Oh my god!
Steiner, not done! So, oh, Jesus!
What the fuck?
Look at the strength! Mother of mercy! The strength of Steiner!
The Steiner recliner!
Steiner's got him! Speaks of an attempt! He's gonna break him in half! He's got Steiner. Now, Big Show could potentially fight out of this. He does have his own variation of the camel clutch called the colossal. But no! Never mind. Big Show did not have the strength tonight.
Steiner beats the Big Show here with the Steiner recliner. But look at this.
This is a beautiful top rope Frankenstein. And then look at this. Look at the strength. Look at the power of Scott Steiner. Look at that.
Lord, and look at this. He had that thing locked in.
He had that locked on perfectly. And now Steiner has picked up his first win in his invitation, the Freakzilla invitation.
And unlike the Blueprint invitation, this one actually had a challenge.
Scott Steiner is legit.
Indeed, Steiner showed that he is legit here tonight on Xplosion Episode 4.
It's an amazing feat of strength by Scott Steiner. Really an impressive matchup. Back, ladies and gentlemen, and well, I'm not entirely sure who this is. Jason.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes Jason Matthews.
That's right, Jason Matthews. I know that by popular opinion, he may not be one of the most popular wrestlers in New-TNA. But you know what? I can't help myself. I like him. I see potential in Jason Matthews.
Jason Matthews, last show on Impact, he basically attacked Trey Owens, locked in that cloverleaf. He caused Owens a victory right after the match. He locked in that Texas cloverleaf and damn near broke Trey Owens' leg.
Yes, in Owens' match against Anderson on the last episode of Xplosion, Anderson was victorious. On the last episode of Impact, Anderson was victorious, and now will be a triple threat at Destination X for the X Division Championship. And who in the hell?
Zach. I guess, folks, you can say this is the popcorn match of Xplosion because.
In the world? Is this Kalen Rogers' cousin, I think?
Yes, this is Freebird Leroy Rogers. He made his debut on Impact in the Blueprint Invitational, and. Yeah.
Did he last the shortest amount of time?
He beat In Darkness. Will almost beat In Darkness on the shortest time.
Yeah, folks, this ain't gonna be a pretty. This ain't gonna be the Chi-Town Rumble. And he's wearing later hoses.
Good.
The fuck this guy. Let's go, Jason Matthews.
Wow.
Jason Matthews pressing on the offense.
This is gonna be a very
look at the agility of Jason Matthews. Look at that. Beautiful
this is
spinning back
a very hard fought match.
And a very impressive leaping elbow drop there by Jason Matthews. Look at the height he got on that just from a standing position. Nice spin kick there by Jason Matthews. Wait a minute. Look at this. Look at that suplex. Look at that beautiful tiger suplex.
It's a very nice tiger suplex.
Ooh. Nice low running drop kick. Now look at this. Look at that. Look at that beautiful side effect there by Jason Matthews.
Oh, since he does a side effect, does that mean he's going to now commit suicide or attempt to it?
If he did, the world would be a very dark place. And look at that. Look at that.
Oh,
beautiful move there by Jason Matthews. All right, game over.
The gold seal by Jason Matthews, and it's over.
Look at that. Yeah. Just look at that. Not even broken a sweat. That's the kind of athlete that Jason Matthews, he just tore through this match. If anyone should be committing suicide after this match, it's Leroy Rogers. And Kalen should assist him in it. And that was just... Jason Matthews just dominated Leroy Rogers. Which, to be fair, isn't something to be ashamed of, considering what a kind of an amazing athlete like Jason Matthews is. But on the other hand, he still, I don't think he even got in a punch. Shame on you, Leroy Rogers. And you wear later hoodies. Shame on you.
Jason acted like he just got out of a 30-minute matchup.
Well, you know, that's the kind of guy Jason Matthews is. He's a showboat. You might say he's a show student. He thinks he's the next big thing, as they might say.
Well, Jason did pick up a win here on Xplosion.
But coming up next, coming up in just a little bit, we'll be having our tag team match as the feuds collide. It'll be Tarver and Evan O'Shea versus Spryder and Arkin in his return match.
This is going to be something else. I mean, these two damn near caused a riot.
Here comes out Tarver first.
Oh, man. This is bringing back some memories.
I do like his entrance. I do like the ambiance.
And basically, this is what Tarver says to people. You can hate me now.
Tarver don't really give a fuck. Tarver's all about him. Tarver doesn't really care about personal opinions. He just likes to knock you out. And, I can respect that. He doesn't care about anyone's opinion but his own.
Tarver here. Basically here. Tarver was attacked by Steven Spryder in his locker room on Impact. I mean, after the kill shot, Mojo basically got disbanded. It's just these two have been going at it.
And the strange thing is that Steven Spryder blames the kill shot that was disbanded by Spryder. And Spryder blames Tarver for the incident or for his recent failing. Even though, if my memory serves, was it not Spryder who took the pin?
Spryder.
Bullshit. Anyway, here comes Evan O'Shea.
Evan O'Shea, man. Evan O'Shea came back. His first match back against Jay Lethal. And it ended with a returning Arkan viciously assaulting Evan O'Shea.
Yes, Arkan blamed O'Shea and general manager Teddy Long for what Arkan believed to be bias against him and trying to protect O'Shea as a reasoning for the fact we haven't seen Arkan in quite some time.
At the time that we do see him, he's in a new TNA ring, and the last thing we see is him giving Evan O'Shea the butterface and just throwing him out of the ring.
O'Shea apparently thinks he is ballin', the most valuable player of new TNA. Perhaps he will be someday, but right now he's just a dude. Speaking of dudes, I said I should say douchebags. Here's one in Steven Spryder.
That's Arkan.
Arkan, I'm sorry. I'm new here. Or not new, but I don't know. I didn't see Arkan. I haven't seen Arkan before.
Right.
You shut up. I am the voice of new TNA. His name is Steven Spryder now.
my colleagues having a Michael Cole moment here. You know, since Arcan's out here, I guess I should be getting my Burb Light out right now, because Matt Eichhorn actually gave me a can of this.
Well, you enjoy that for a moment, but let me just say that Arcan is really just one of those intense and dangerous individuals in New TNA. He is obsessed with making a statement by any means necessary. And I like to call him the Australian Nightmare.
He is a dangerous man. My God, last impact, I just saw. Oh, here we go. Here comes Steven Spryder. And this time it is Steven Spryder.
You shut your face with Kentucky Fried Watermelon. Yes, Steven
That's
Spryder.
That's the best you can come up with.
You shut up. Steven Spryder. Really, when I see Steven Spryder. Really, when I see Steven Spryder, all I see is a lot of wasted potential. Steven Spryder, he has the talent, he has the skill to be something in New TNA. However, he's wasting his time obsessing over this tag team, or obsessing over the failures of the Killshot Dojo. Regardless of whose fault it was or who is the weak link, it wasn't working out. But Spryder will not accept even the slightest chance that failing might be his, and he won't stop until this business with Carver is finished.
We'll be right back here. We'll be right back.
And we're back, and this match getting set to kick off, and right now it's Arcan, I think, and Michael Tarver locking it up. Tarver transitioning to that side headlock, now back into the armbar.
Yeah.
Both men exchanging some scientific holds right here, and I like this. Some good old-fashioned chain wrestling. Oh! Chain wrestling, that just kicked to the gut, and then a kick to the back of the head.
Sorry about that burp, ladies and gentlemen. That burp light got to me.
Yeah, it has an effect on most people. Now Arcan continuing with those kicks. And now with a vicious knee to the face, followed by a bulldog.
Shades of a certain Second City Saint.
You might say that Arcan's fires of rage burn always.
Unfortunately, he's no cult of personality.
Indeed.
And Tarver.
And we will not be setting him free. Tarver now, with a full Nelson slam.
Very nice, full Nelson slam by Tarver.
Now Tarver with those punches to the head. He does have the ability to knock someone out in 1.9 seconds, I do believe.
Yes, he does.
Tarver continuing the assault.
Boss man slam, you can say it.
Yes. I won't quite say what it is, because that might be construed as racist, but let's just say that move was abysmal. And now, O'Shea coming in with the assisted crossbody there from Tarver. O'Shea getting his chance against Arcan, and now going for the early pin. One, two. No! Not even a two count. Spryder in there to break it up.
Now having O'Shea back on the offense. Look at this.
Now a nice T-bone suplex there. Hooking the knee. Now kick his back. O'Shea getting in his licks. And now here comes. Now he's going to go with some shots here. Some good stiff strikes and a nice kick to the jaw there. Nice spinning kick.
Very nice.
Now continuing the offense. Wait a minute. Going to go for some kind of double underhook move. And no.
Oh.
Arcan with it. Spun out of it. Kick to the gut. And now. Look at this.
Oh!
Oh!
Just reverse overdrive.
Yes. Inverted overdrive, just smashing the back of Evans' neck across his knee, and now...
I mean, the thing between O'Shea and Arcan started because Arcan was suspended for kicking Evan O'Shea's ass so much during their first match.
I'd like to call that unnecessary roughness. And now, or unsportsmanlike conduct, you might say, in some other sports. And now it's Spryder coming into the match. Spryder working on the leg of Evan O'Shea. Now just continuing to go back to that leg.
Working on the legs of Evan O'Shea, which is one of Evan's strong points, his legs.
So we've seen Evan with plenty of kicks so far in the match, and now it's just a headbutt. Yes, O'Shea is a bit of a high flyer now. And now, a House of Pain type maneuver. A painful house. Of course, O'Shea is also mainly a mat wrestler. However, even in mat wrestling, the legs are an important component because they are the foundation of the wrestler's maneuverability. Whoa.
That's indeed right. Oh, tilt-a-whirl backbreaker there.
And now Spryder trying to go in for a cover on O'Shea.
One,
two. No, Tarver just able to break it up.
Tarver with the save.
And now sending O'Shea into the ropes.
Whoa.
And here comes Arcan again.
He's in dangerous territory.
And now an assisted crossbody of his own by Arcan.
Oh my god. Very nice assist to cross body there. Now, oh.
Now, kick to the back. Arcan going to work.
Arcan almost stalking Evan.
Now, Evan, look at it. Or now, Arcan. Oh, it's slamming.
Oh, god, the curb stomp.
Vicious curb stomp.
Same curb stomp he used on Impact. Oh, yeah,
O'Shea. Evan tries on them, but Arcan saying, go fuck yourself. And now, a vicious knee right to the bridge of the nose. Trying to break O'Shea's nose, and oh my
Jesus.
Goodness! The knee just spun Evan around.
Knee trembler. Shades
One,
of William Regal.
Two. No.
Tarver again with the save.
Tarver definitely is keeping. Oh my
Holy
goodness!
Crap.
A thunderous enziguri, and back in comes Steven Spryder.
I mean, that one you can obviously tell that Arcan wanted to take Evan's head off.
Nice rolling mat technique there by Steven Spryder, and now throwing O'Shea into the corner. Evan O'Shea is getting picked apart. He has to get back to his corner.
Ooh.
He has to find whatever opening he can to get back in some offense, and then just leap to his corner. Fly if he has to, and now look at this diving European uppercut by O'Shea.
Very nice.
Now just stomping on the face of Evan O'Shea.
Spryder's in full control of Evan O'Shea here.
Spryder Arcan connection just dominating right now.
Oh. Now look at this.
Oh! Consistent boot to the face there.
Arcan
with the ropes!
Really? Really now?
One! Two!
Two!
No! O'Shea able to wheel himself out at that point. No! Oh, no! Arcan
reversal.
Security. Evan O'Shea had it scouted, now with a sleeper slam.
Very nice sleeper slam. O'Shea
now,
getting back into this.
There's those legs. There's those kicks. And now O'Shea going back on the offense. Giving Arcan everything he's got. Another nice wheel kick there. And it's picking him up. Send him into the corner, but not quite the right corner. And he's raining on those shots there on Arcan. What's coming up now?
Oh, wait a minute.
He's got him in the armory. Oh, look at this, look at this! Whoa, nice lucha arm drag there. Very impressive.
Very nice. He's showing that training that he's showing all that training off that he's done since he's been away from New TNA.
And now Tarver coming in. Tarver with those body shots. And Arcan just goes flying to the outside.
Tarver raining down punches here.
Arcan wanting no part of Michael Tarver. Tarver not giving him any other options.
Indeed. And since Tarver is the fresh man in, he's about to lay down some punishment.
Look at this. Oh my goodness!
Holy crap!
Crackerjack like maneuver there by Michael Tarver.
He flung Arcan like a sack of Aussie potatoes.
Indeed, and now Arcan going back in the ring and Tarver coming with him and nice pull up there. And Arcan has been. Oh, that's a nasty cut. Arcan is busted over. Heavy shot there to the back.
The irony of that is just delicious. Arkham promised the bloody era.
New TNA, and Arkham is the one who is bleeding.
Ho ho ho.
Ha ha.
Delicious now, irony, good sir.
Indeed. And now, here comes with the
drop to hold.
Drop to hold and the elbow drop. Evan O'Shea back in the mix. Now O'Shea, what's O'Shea got Check. Here?
Oh, look at this!
Oh! Very nice flip there. What's this? One.
No. The name escapes me of that move that Evan O'Shea did.
Indeed,
but
I
that was impressive.
Oh my, a nice nice move there by Arkin. But as far as the name of Evan's move, I think you may have spent too much time in the West Ganyan sun, perhaps, and your brain has been addled by... Oh my! Slingshot crossbody there, very impressive.
And a kick to the back.
Now
O'Shea.
Working
on the legs here.
Let's put him on the Celtic, or put him on the Irish knot. Celtic knot. Shades of the great fit Finley. Now, no, Arkin. Fighting back with that poke to the eyes.
Now playing dirty here.
Oh, my. That jumping back or neck breaker.
Or you can say a jumping reverse STO bulldog-like maneuver.
Indeed. I believe Arkin thinks himself perfection. And now, Spryder going on the attack.
Look at this. Evan O'Shea fighting out of this.
Look at the heart. Look at the will of Evan O'Shea. And now, the very impressive moves by Evan O'Shea, just refusing to die down. Look at that DDT.
Evan O'Shea is fighting for his life almost in this ring.
Evan O'Shea is fighting to prove himself. He has had one victory so far in New TNA. He feels the need to make an impact. And now with the cover. No.
No, pun intended.
On the rope. Yes, didn't notice that myself. And now, now Spryder able to dodge. No, vicious European uppercut.
Very nice European uppercut. No. And another one.
And now maybe you go, no, not go for third. Look at this, headbutt to the back of the head.
Man.
Now, that amateur roll again, just disorienting O'Shea. And now, Spryder got in mind.
Wait a minute.
Oh, elbow drop right to the back of the skull. No! Evan O'Shea fighting back. But no. Spryder having none of it. And now that vicious elbow to the back of the head. Now Spryder. Spryder got in mind. Oh,
Evan. Irish whip.
He's going into the corner. Irish whip. Going up top. Look at this. For a superplex. He's going to get it.
Oh boy.
Superplex!
Oh god.
What maneuver!
That has to be killing Evan O'Shea's back right now.
Evan O'Shea's back has to be in so much pain. Because the opposing team has just been targeting the back all night. And now, Spryder just continuing with the strikes.
Oh, wait a minute.
What's this?
The GTS!
Go to sleep, bitch! Go to sleep! Is this it?
Evan O'Shea went to sleep and he's not Daniel.
One, two, three. Tarver just a second too late.
The same move that laid Tarver out last impact is the move that picked up the victory for Arkan and Steven Spark.
Look at this, Arkan, despite promising a bloodier era, is the only person who was actually busted open here tonight. And a very solid showing by O'Shea and Tarver, taking nothing away from them. But cards just weren't in their favor tonight. They went up against a very game Spryder and Arkin. And, I don't know. Those two just jumped so well together. Perhaps the tag division of NBA may continue to grow after tonight.
May have been, but big win for Arkin and Spryder. Kudos to Evan O'Shea and Tarver, but Spryder and Arkan were the better team tonight.
It was a very good match. Sorry that people didn't quite get the win team that they were hoping for, but, Spryder and Arkan pleased themselves, and to be quite honest, they've every right to be. Horrified match. Congrats to everybody.
Indeed. And folks, This has been.
Wait a minute!
Oh! Tarver attacking Spider now.
Tarver having none of this. Tarver wanting his say in the matter. Jesus, just turn Spider inside with that big boot and, oh my, what's down here? Big clubbing blow to the back. Tarver is all over Spider like a wild animal, and oh my.
Oh God. Tarver and Spider weren't in the match at the same time. And
oh, wait, Jesus! He just punched, he just destroyed that chair with that punch, and oh my.
Look, it's oh my God.
One of those choke tosses. And now
I figured after course. Impact, these two were not going to stop wanting to beat the hell out of each other, and I was right.
We weren't done yet, and now Tarver, and now Spider's back in the ring of Tarver, and look at this, another blow to the back of the head. And oh my, there's that exposed steel. This can't be good.
This cannot. This is not good. Oh God!
Oh jeez! Oh my! Oh, Spider's busted open. Good Lord! Look at Spider's face.
Tarver is
in blood.
Tarver is freaking slamming Spider's head into that exposed steel.
This is at least one of the
moves. Oh God!
Knockout.
Kill shot. The kill shot. By kill B. I'm gonna tell you right now, I am not hating Tarver right now.
Come on. Spider won the match, but Tarver got the last word in.
My God. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been New TNA Xplosion. I am Loud in Styles.
I'm Zach Shore. Good night, everybody. My God.